I'm going to jump in and show you a technology demonstration. It's really a walkthrough of article creation on the elcomCMS, which offers a unique accessibility check as you type, in addition to the Microsoft Word check that Kim just referred to. So the tool online will actually check for proper structure, text sizing, and make sure of insertion of things like alt text. It also checks table accessibility on a cell-by-cell level and provides a table accessibility wizard for the user to directly create tables with the required accessibility markup. So let's take a closer look. And to do this, I'm going to be doing a live demonstration. And I'm just going to switch monitors so you can take a look at what I'm seeing. Okay, and let's open up this Word document. I've just removed the image because I'd like to pop that back in a moment, so hopefully you can all see the screen. So it is common that content creation for the web starts in Microsoft Word. So I've prepared this content, which you can see in your screen, which is currently not formatted, and I'm going to leave it unformatted for the purpose of this demo. You can see here I've got some paragraphs. I'll remove that heading of priority one. I've got a table. I also have some additional subheadings, which I'll actually remove the subheading, formatting, and some unordered lists. I will go ahead now and actually add an image to the content. I've prepared an image which is sitting on my desktop, which is a desert panorama. Now, alt text can be added at this point, but I'm not going to do that. Now, using the MS Word plugin, this content can be published directly to the elcomCMS. So I click up here on the tab. First thing I should do actually is save my document locally. And once I've saved locally, I can go ahead and click the Publish button, and you'll see that the elcomCMS Word plugin web service authenticates me using Active Directory and then presents me the folders of the site for which I have access and publishing rights to. So I'm going to select the demonstration folder, and it grabs the file name and pops that in as the page title for me. I can also go ahead and just add a brief description. And I'm just going to keep monitoring your screen refreshes to make sure that you're catching up with what I'm doing. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead now and publish the article. And the Elcom web service will grab that article, publish it up to my elcomCMS website, and then load the page for me. So you're seeing the uploading and the transfer. And in a moment, you'll see the browser window open and display the lovely content. Now, it is using the built-in template, so it's automatically styled my H1 heading, but the rest of the document isn't really styled. I have no alt text. I have no subheadings. So there's a bunch of things that I've done here which create problems for someone for guidelines. So if I go ahead and click the Edit button, this will allow me to drop into the content and edit this page. Now I'm going to flick over to our editor. We have a couple of flavors of editors in the elcomCMS. It is the eFox editor which provides the accessibility checking as you type function. Now using the accessibility as you type is as easy as using a typical spell checker. So you can easily enable or disable this feature from the toolbar or the menu. So you can see here I've got a button here, an option here on the drop-down menu, and I've also got a button over here on the toolbar. So I'm going to enable that. What it's going to do now is run through the document and display a little icon next to any of the items where accessibility compliance is either showing an error or a warning. So you can mouse over that icon and get a brief description of the error. So you can see here my table has a few issues. Now for a more comprehensive assessment, an accessibility report, which and this provides you with a detailed analysis of the accessibility error. The author can specify which guidelines to apply when creating this report. So, you know, publishing for part of the world, you might choose different guidelines. In the US, Section 508. Here in Australia, we're targeting priority 2. So I'll table the Section 508 and WCAG priority 1 warnings. The checklist is automatically updated and expands or contracts in its scope. Now, for each accessibility identified, the report shows brief description of the action required by the author to solve the error. The author wishes to read the fine detail of the guideline and can also click, which will attach the guideline text on the web. This gives you an idea of how the accessibility score works. What I now is out of this article. I'll actually go ahead and trash this content using the trash icon at the top of the screen. And I'll jump back into Word. And this time, let's go ahead and actually apply appropriate styles and formatting. So I'll bold the name of the author. Over here, I'll actually go in and format the picture and add some alt text. Okay, so there's our alt text that's been added to the image. Scrolling down on the priority one checkpoint, I'll use the built-in style and formatting that Word provides using the heading 2, which will be translated into an H2 when it reaches the website. If I go ahead and do inline formatting that's not in accord with the styles and formatting, that will be removed on import or upload. I'll also set an H2 on another subheading. And now that this has been corrected, we can go ahead and publish this back to the website. So I'll just go ahead and save this as a separate version. Hit that publish button again. Target the demo folder. Give us a brief description. This time it's called my accessible. Cool. Opt for format to be cleaned, hit the publish button, and again, this will be transferred up to the website. Okay, so you should be seeing it on your screens now. You can now see that the formatting has been transferred. I now have the correct formatting for the author's name. We also have alt text on the image, which you'll see in a minute as we jump into the content. You can see that the formatting has been applied appropriately for headings as well, bullet lists, and the table. So let's jump in and run that checker one more time. Okay, so here we are at the content, turning on that checker. You can now see if we run the accessibility report, you know, that the warnings are far fewer. So there are obviously some manual checks here. These are kind of things that the computer check, and it's just advising you to take a look at. But you can see that the only issue that it's found now with our content is check the use of headings. Now it's noticed that I have a heading 2 without a heading 1, which is valid, but that's actually something which is catered for in my template. So I can go ahead and publish this content and be confident that it has passed my my accessibility checks. So you can see that the heading 1 was baked into the template, and heading 2 commences at a lower level. Now this method was for creating content via Microsoft Word, but obviously if we create a new piece of content on the CMS, directly in the CMS, similar rules are applied. So if I click the Add Article button and just create some new content, and I'll go ahead and target the same folder, and this time I'll select a specific template, and I'll go ahead and create that. And you can see my new page instantly being created. I can now drop into the editor. You can set your default to your preferred editor. And when that editor loads, we can have it defaulted to ensure that accessibility checking as you type is enabled. And as I start to add content such as tables, you can see instantly that the warnings appear. Adding an image. If there's no alt text on this image, there actually happens to be alt text on this image, which is obviously good, but there shouldn't be. So if there was actually no alt text on this image, then you'll see the checker will automatically throw a warning telling me that I'm in breach of the various guidelines. Okay, so in addition to accessibility checking, it's also important to point out that the actual editing interface itself is also accessible. Icons, shortcut keys, and context-sensitive right-click menus provide alternative access to features that are also found on the drop-down menus. So case studies have shown that web authors using publishing tools such as this have been able to reduce compliance errors identified post-publication by more than 90%. So this is really the place to cover the issues first up. And also an important tool, as Kim mentioned, for post-December 2012. You know, you don't just have to be compliant on 1st of January, but you need to make sure that your team can easily continue to be compliant, and using tools such as this will hopefully go a long way to ensuring that your content you know, stays accessible. So that's it from me and the demo. I hope the screen refreshes were quick enough to actually make sense by the webinar. I hope that it's been useful for you. And now I'm going to hand back to Kim.